Hi, welcome to the Clover Salon Scheduler Quick Start video. Let's get started. First thing you want to do is you want to add everything you sell into the inventory of your Clover. You can do that using the inventory app on your Clover device, or you can log into your Clover web dashboard on clover.com and you can use the inventory tab. Either way, let's just use the inventory app here. You want to go to the items category here and see add item right here. I'm going to add an item. Let's say I add a men's hair cut. You're going to give it, let's say this is a fixed price item and the price of the item is $14.99. I'm going to tap save. That's how you add an item into your inventory. That's something you sell. You can add all the items you sell, your services as well as your products. After you do that, you want to group your items into categories. That's really just a meaningful way to organize everything you sell, and also to help you with your books and everything, okay? So let's just make a new category. You can tap the little plus right here. I'm gonna call this category haircuts. And in this category, once you make it, I'm gonna tap the little pencil right here. And see, it's saying you don't have any items in this category. And you can choose what items you wanna add into here. So you can find, like I just made a item called men's haircut. I'm gonna make sure there, in this category called haircuts, I've added the item called men's haircuts or men's haircut. I could also add a women's haircut, a child's haircut. Whatever you do, you want to make sure, again, add all your items that you sell into the items in your Clover. Then organize all your items you sell into categories, whether it's a service or a product. When you're done with that, the next thing you want to do is add all of your employees. And your employees are anyone that can sell something on your Clover, or someone that you want to make sure that has access to your Clover, okay? So you can add a new employee by hitting the plus sign right here, give them a name and a nickname, a passcode, that's very important because they'll use that to log in later on to their scheduler on their phone, their role, and you also want to make sure that you give an email address. You really can't change this information very easily later on, so try to make sure you provide all this information and make sure it's correct at the time you set it up, okay? After you set up all of your employees, you're ready to set up the scheduler. Again, what you've done is you've added all the items you sell into your inventory, you've organized your items into the categories, and you've created all your employees. Then you go to the scheduler. It's a scissor icon with a tan background. Tap on the scheduler, and it's gonna come up. And the first thing you probably wanna do is tap on this question mark right here. Tap send getting started info to my phone. You can enter your cell phone number and hit done. And what we're gonna do is we'll send you a text message full of a lot of help videos, our email address, how to contact us, as well as some important links for your online scheduling and just different things you need, including your merchant token, which will let you log into your other apps, like on your phones and on your Windows devices. Okay, to set up the scheduler, you're gonna tell the scheduler, hey, out of all the items that I sell, you need to tell the scheduler which ones are actually services, and you need to tell the scheduler, hey, out of all the employees you have, which ones actually perform services. Okay, so you tap on the three lines here. Every time you tap on the three lines, we do an audit. That means we compared any changes you made in your Clover inventory, because sometimes you make changes, that's the way we know about them. First thing you wanna do is tap on merchant settings, and you wanna tap on the online scheduling settings, okay? And what that's gonna let you do is decide a few features here. Does your bank accept Amex? Does your bank accept Discover? You probably don't wanna use employee first booking, but you can if you're gonna do online scheduling. You can decide if your customer chooses the employee first or chooses services first. Bookhead hours determine the earliest time that someone can book online, and you usually set it to 2 so someone can't like cheat in line or something. They have to wait at least 2 hours to be able to find a slot. How many months ahead you can book. Require credit card on hold. You want to turn this on. The way you turn something on is you tap it, and then you can tap yes or no, okay? And you want to turn this on if you're going to take a card on hold for customers that book online. Are you going to charge a deposit at the time that they book, or are you only going to charge them if they're a no-show? If you're only charging if they're a no-show, make sure that's a no. Enable waitlist. That's a new feature that we have not fully implemented, but when ready, you'll see a button on your online scheduling where a customer can be put on the wait list. What is the default deposit charge? This can be percent or dollars. So you can change that from percent sign to a dollar sign. And that's how much you'll be charged for a no-show. You can use the coupon features. You know, if you have a coupon code, you can have the customer put in that coupon code, and they get an automatic discount when they check out. Now, while you're at it, you can set a bunch of other features. You could tap on each of these blue buttons here, like control features. You're going to see all the control features, prompt register for employee, use nicknames, a lot of different printing things. You also have the features for the appearance of the scheduler. Now, if you like black lines or blue lines, displaying a time bar or not, various features you can use there for reporting. And we also have our lab features. We now have the ability for you to schedule products as well as services on an appointment. And you can actually enable a card to take a card for appointments that you make within the salon. When you're done, make sure you tap done and save and exit. Okay. Next thing you're going to do is tap on service settings and services by category. This is going to show you a list of all of your categories that you've set up in your Clover. Tap on the category, one of the categories that contains your services. It's going to show you every item that's in that category. See, it's under this group called non-service items. That means it just thinks it's a product right now. But you can tap on the item and you can say recognize a service, and then you can provide a duration by tapping on it, as well as a break duration, a finish duration. The display order, that can be any number, like if you put a one there, it'll appear first in your list of services to select for an appointment. You can also create a combination now. If this combination pop-up was on, then every item that has the same combination group number is going to appear as a sub-selection. So like if you picked a haircut and you also wanted a blow dry with it, you can make the blow dry have the same combination number and make the haircut have the trigger as a yes. That means whenever you add a haircut to an appointment, it'll pop up a list of other items with the same combination group, so you can choose from those as well. Is it visible online? The online section heading refers to, like, it's basically like a category, but this is the name of this item will appear under online. So make sure you change that. You can add a description for your customers to see. And if you have a custom hold amount, you can change the default hold amount. If you're paying your employee's commission, make sure you add the employee commission. You can also turn the service off if you need. If you're using service colors, which was one of the options under the merchant settings under appearance, then you can change the color of this men's haircut by tapping on the actual color right here. When you're done, just tap done and you can save your changes. Okay. Now I want to show you something else. If there were a number of items that were listed here, let's just go back to a different category. Okay. See, if you picked a different category and there's a number of items that appear, you can change all the items that appear all at the same time by tapping on the blue area. If I did right now, I would be changing the category, I would change the parameters for all five of these items all at the same time. So I can do that right now. Changes apply to all these items that are listed below. Okay. Or, you know what I could have done? Here's, you could search for a particular keyword, like PLU in this case. Now, if I tap the service items, I'll make changes to two items at the same time. Okay, does that make sense? So whatever you're searching for, if you tap the blue area, you'll make changes to whatever you're searching for all at the same time by tapping in the blue area. Okay, so that can help you make a lot of changes all at the same time. Okay, but whenever you're done, you want to tap the X, and it's going to, I've already saved changes, so that's already been saved. After you're done with that, what you want to do, the very last thing, so next thing you want to do is make sure you turn on all of your services that you've created. You're telling the scheduler that these are the items that are actually services and not products. Last thing you want to do is tap on employee settings. And every employee that performs a service, you want to make them turned on for performing online, if they're performing online, as well as if they're performing services. Okay. And then you want to tap on the settings button on each employee and tap on weekly schedule. Now see right here, you can decide the default is Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 with no break, but you can turn them on or off for each day of the week. And you can change the slider to decide what time they work. You can also tap on it to increase it a little at a time. And you can also turn on a break if there's a break. This is the weekly schedule for each employee that will be used. It's primarily used for customers who schedule online. Okay. Then you want to tap done and save changes. So you want to do that for each and every employee, set their hours. If you have customizations, you can tap on service times, commissions, and details. We'll show you every service that this particular employee offers. You can tap on each service and you can change if each service is offered by a particular employee or not. If it's bookable online, custom durations for each service for each employee. And you can even add a custom price for each employee for each price if it's a variable priced item, okay? So when you're done, those are all the customizations. You can also customize the commission for each employee. So make sure you do that for all of your employees. And after you're done, you're ready to book your first appointment. Okay, so you're gonna see each employee listed at the top. To book an appointment, by the way, let's finish with employees. You can tap on an employee's name at the top, and you can tab add, edit, view time on or off. What this will let you do is it'll let you add an extra working time. Let me give it a little pin code here. But you can add extra hours that you work in addition to the weekly schedule. So you can tap the little plus right here, provide the start time, end time, the number of days in a row, and even a reason for the time off, or you can set it to a time on, okay? Either way, that's how you can add time on and time off that's in addition to your weekly schedule, okay? To make an appointment, you tap anywhere underneath the employees column. To make an appointment, you wanna tap on at least one customer, which you can search for. When you search for a customer, you can tap on the customer's name and we'll show you all the information. This customer has a particular preference and we'll let you know. You can change a customer's preference for which employee they want, who they're referred by, if it's Instagram, Facebook, or whatever other option. You can make this appointment a waitlist after you've added services and a date. You can add a card on file if you chose that option under merchant settings. You'll see all the notes for that customer. You can also tap on history. We'll show you their previous Clover order history, which you can tap on to see the details, their previous appointment history, as well as if they had any no-show history, you would see that. You can add a new note also. So this is all the information for the customer. Then you can, again, you can tap on the date and you can change the time. Let's say the appointment was for 4:30 p.m. Then you can tap on services and add which services are being offered for that particular appointment. You can tap on edit and you can change the particular employee that's offering that particular service because you can add more than one service on that appointment and each one can be done by a different employee. You can add products, which you have to do a search for your products. We did that mainly because a lot of salons will have too many products and it's just too hard to show them all or even to pick them all. So make sure you add at least one service, one customer, and a date and time, and you can tap done. We're gonna ask you a confirmation and we're going to add the appointment onto your book. Now, this little icon right here tells you if it's an open envelope, it means we haven't sent the reminder out. If it's a closed envelope, it means we sent the reminder out. If it's a clipboard with a check mark, it means that we've sent that the customer has responded with a confirmation. If it's a clipboard with an X, it means they're requesting a cancel. You have to decide what to do about that. If it's a clipboard with a magnifying glass, it means they've responded with something else like I'm running late or something. And you can tap on the appointment and tap on the notes and you'll see what they actually responded with. If you're a subscriber to the Platinum plan, you get up to 3 reminders per appointment and you'll see 3 little check marks appear right here. This RR here means return request. It means that this particular customer has requested a particular employee. They're not open to any stylist. They really want a particular employee. Okay, to update an appointment, you just tap on the appointment itself. You can make any changes you want. For example, you can change it to 3:30. Can change any services you want and just tap done. That's how you'd make an update to an appointment. You could have changed the employee or anything else you wanted for that appointment. To check it out, you tap on the appointment and you're going to see a big old box here that says checkout. You can tap check in. You have features where you can print a printout at the same time of the check in. That mainly changes color so you know that someone's checked in. If they were a no show, you could tap the no show. If they had a card on file, then we would tell you this customer has a card on file and ask you if you wish to charge them in the amount. If they booked online, this would have a dollar sign no show. The dollar sign tells you that they've already confirmed a particular amount. When you tap this button, it would be a note, they would be marked as a no show. And at the same time, we would go ahead and charge their card on file. You'll see a little star in front if they have a card on file, but they didn't book online and they still have a card on file. Okay, you can view their notes, you can delete the appointment. If you have more than one appointment, you're checking out at the same time, add each appointment to the basket and tap checkout on the very last appointment and you can check it out. You can also print it, you can edit it, you can do whatever you need to that particular appointment. But mainly when you check out, what we're doing is we're creating a Clover order. We're adding every item that was on your particular order to that order and we're putting you on the Clover register. Then you can add your other items that you're offering. Make sure that you can add those to your, we'll ask you which employee gets credit for each item so we can track commission. You can turn that off under the merchant settings, under the control features. After you're done, you can tap pay. You can pay out the particular ticket. And when you're done, just tap this little back arrow and you'll be back at the scheduler. Okay, so that's a quick start on how to get going. This navigation calendar here can help you a little bit. What it's gonna give you is a little dot for each employee that has an appointment on a particular day. So you can quickly see where you're at. You can tap on lists. You can do an appointment search immediately with three or more letters, or you can change using this little date button. You can change the how far back and how far forward you do your searches. You can tap on the list right here, change to list your customers. You can view your wait list, or you can view your online block list, okay? By the way, if you wanted to add a customer to the wait list, you could tap, act like you're making an appointment, and you're gonna get an option. After you've chosen at least one service in a date and time, you'll be able to choose wait list right here. And instead of creating an appointment, that's gonna put that customer on the wait list so you can later on see which customers are on that wait list by just tapping right here and going to view wait list. Okay, now we have other videos that'll help you with adding your online scheduling is being set up as you set up your scheduler, so it's already ready for you. The link that you can add to your Book Now button, you can get that link again by tapping this Send Getting Started Info to My Phone. It's gonna send you your link to your online scheduling as well as how to get a hold of us. You can send an email, we give you an email address, help@appheaven.us. And if you email that address with a pic of your salon, as well as any custom text, we'll add that to your online scheduling site. To log into your Windows or your iPhone or your Android phone, you can find our Clover Salon Scheduler by searching for it on the appropriate app store. On Android, make sure you search for New Clover Salon Scheduler. The merchant token, you tap merchant token right here, you can see it. We also put it on the text message that we sent you. Okay, so feel free to reach out to us. We're very available for you. We'll be glad to help you. You can even schedule an extended training session if you need it. This is meant to be a quick start, but it should really help you with how to get going quickly.